Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded a decent price decline, so the pullback continues. The prices of the major cryptocurrencies, they have been trading in the red zone for the last 24 hours and even for the last 7 days. And the prices, they continue to decline to some extent. So let's have a look at the price of Bitcoin. And today, I just once again want to share my point of view on the current situation in the cryptocurrency market and to share my point of view about, in general, the direction of the cryptocurrency market. And so, because many people ask me what I think, keeping in mind that I have almost 15 years experience in the financial world as a chartist, as a fundamental analysis, working in the stock market, forex market for many years, cryptocurrency market as well, and so on. Of course, first of all, based on my almost 15 years experience in the financial market, I just want to iterate once again that it's not a financial recommendation. I don't claim that I am right. The longer you are in the market, the more you understand that it's wrong to claim that your point of view is the only one, the right one. I just claim that this is just my point of view. I don't know what's going on, what is going to happen in the market, but I am just going to share my point of view because people ask me. Now, this is how the price chart of Bitcoin looks like. We will have a look at some other price charts as well, but this is the price chart of Bitcoin. And this is, let's say, the bear market in 2018, then the period of solid consolidation in 2018, 19, etc., when the market was moving sideways. And now let me remind you some of my observations. So the market started to increase in the last months of 2020, so in the last months of previous years. And I remember that when the market hit 20,000, many people, they booked their profit and they said, that's it, the bubble will burst, it's going to dip once again to 10,000, let's exit the market. But there were some other people who continued to hold their cryptocurrency. But many newbies who entered the market, I remember very well that during this price increase here, when the Bitcoin was approaching 30,000, 40,000, 50,000, I saw many, mainly new entrants to the market claiming on a daily basis in Twitter, in other social media platforms such as Hive and etc., Facebook, saying that I regret I didn't bought more cryptocurrency earlier. And they used to claim, my bags are never full enough, I need more crypto. So they used to claim that they need more crypto, they're ready to buy crypto if it dips, and they want to buy more because now they realize that crypto is the future, but they didn't bought in this, let's say, dip here or stagnation, because at that moment the market was kind of bearish, so they were scared. So here they used to claim that if the market dips, they are going to buy. There are many people like this, and they used to claim, I would like to buy much more of this currency, much more of this currency, this one, if the market dips. Now what happens? Here is the dip. The market is declining. We are experiencing a pullback. Interestingly, or even ironically, I have noticed that exactly almost the same people who used to claim that they're ready to buy the dip, they regret they didn't vote here because here they thought that the market is in a bearish trend and the market Bitcoin will dip to $1,000 and to $100. I remember people claiming that the Bitcoin, the price of Bitcoin will dip to $100. Now they claim that here they claim that they regret they didn't vote. They didn't buy. And now when the market is experiencing this dip, exactly these people, they claim that this is the beginning of the trend reversal. They are panicking, they are selling, they are exiting the market. The market will drop further and etc. And then I want to say, I have seen this many, many times in the different financial markets. The same people, when the price is increasing, they want lower prices and they claim at lower prices they are going to buy more. However, when we experiencing some dips in our case, these dips, exactly these people, they are the ones that they even sell their crypto. They're exiting the market instead of sticking to their strategy of buying additional crypto. So this is just my observation. Is it some kind of recommendation? I don't know. It's just an observation that I wanted to share. And I have seen this scenario many times in the different financial markets. It's not a recommendation. I don't claim that the price will continue to increase or decrease. This is just my observation. That the same people who used to claim here that they're ready to buy if the prices go lower because they want more and they don't have enough, now they're the ones who are panicking and calling and asking and talking about selling and exiting. Some people even exited the market waiting for the price to dip further. I don't know. It's not a recommendation. Now, what I want to say is, let me add some interesting technical indicators to the price chart of Bitcoin. So this is the price chart of Bitcoin. Let me add, in this case, I will add this time three moving averages. The first one is the 30-day moving average. So this is the monthly or the 30-day moving average. The next one is the 90-day moving average. So in our case, it is the 3-month moving average. And yes, we spotted this crossover, moving average crossover, a couple of days ago. I even mentioned it 2 or 3 or 4 times in my analysis. Yes, that's a typical trend reversal bearish signal. However, I said here that it's too early to claim that this is the trend reversal of this bullish trend. I still think it's too early. Yes, it's an indicator at that moment that indicated that we may experience a deeper correction, not like this one, much deeper. And yes, we're experiencing this correction. At which level the price will stabilize, I have no idea. We're still in this correction. It may continue, it may end, we will keep an eye on it. So far, I haven't seen any trend reversal signal indicating to potential rebound, but it may happen at any point. We may further dip, I don't know, but I want to say that yes, we have this moving average crossover here, but I do not think that this is an indicator 100% showing that this is the end of this bull trend. I still think that we're at the very, very beginning of the bull trend. Now, where, in my view, I want to say, this dip may end. It could be it ends here, but let me add also the 1-year moving average. So the 1-year moving average, 360 days in our case. Okay, 365, but it's almost the same in our case. So this is the 360 days moving average turned to yearly or the 1-year moving average. I think this is the solid support. It seems that the price even already approached it. It may turn out that that was the end of this dip, because the price almost approached it. And now I want to say that even if we experience some another dip, I think that within this range here, the price will receive support and resume the uptrend slowly but steadily, removing all margin and leverage traders during this dip, because we need a sustainable growth, not based on leverage trading, at least in my view. I'm not against the margin and leverage traders. I've been doing it for many years. I continue to use platforms which provide leverage and margin. But I keep in mind all these dips and downs in the different financial markets. So my trading approach is completely different. And that's why I don't want to say that the market needs sustainability without leverage. So now, what I expect, the price may drop to this range. Hence, it will test this local high approximately. I mean, approximately it will test this line here. Within this range, approaching the previous local high. However, it may resume the uptrend from here, for example. It may resume the uptrend a bit later. It may resume the uptrend from the current price level. I don't know at which level this will happen, but I do think that this is a local low that is at the very beginning of the bull market. that will just test the sustainability of this uptrend. That is at the very beginning. And I want to say that a few days ago, I outlined something similar, testing this key bearish, let's say, border in the price chart of Litecoin. If we go to the price chart of Ethereum, we have something similar like in the price chart of Bitcoin. But now, let me remove all this and move to the price chart of another cryptocurrency that has a longer chart, not a cryptocurrency that has existed for a couple of months or a year or two. That is at least 5 or 6 years old to be able to apply these moving averages. And on purpose, from these ones here, I showed Litecoin a few days ago to take Uniswap, Chainlink, Solana, Binance, Polygon, Ethereum Classic, and so on. I think it's not appropriate because most of them are young cryptocurrency. Ethereum Classic is very similar to Ethereum. Tron is young cryptocurrency. I can take EOS, but let me show you, for example, Monero. And this is Monero. And I want to show you something really very interesting. However, I will use Bitfinex. This is the price chart of Monero. Let me hide these moving averages. Although I want to show that we have here in the price chart ascending moving averages. It's a little bit different. So it is a confirmation that the bull trend continues, but the price has tested the yearly moving average, like in the price chart of Bitcoin as well. But let me remove these moving averages. I want to highlight something important. So this is the bear market in 2018 in the price chart of Monero, a descending triangle with a lower line that later formed the neckline of this double bottom. So this is the neckline. That was the border separating the bullish part of the chart and the bearish part. And we analyzed this double bottom many times, not only in the price chart of Monero, but also of many other old cryptocurrencies that have old longer charts. This is a typical trend reversal technical pattern, double bottom. And last year, in the last months and in the very first months of this year, I outlined this formation in many price charts. For example, somewhere we saw that we had this double bottom or triple bottom or inverted head and shoulders, or inverted crown. All these technical patterns are typical trend reversal technical formation. Talking about trend reversal, I have in mind this, that they revoke, they cancel the bearish trend, and they were the initial signal indicating to the beginning of a new bull market. And the bull market started. However, interestingly, after this solid price increase, the price decided to test the neckline. And once again, I want to say that I think that the price won't be able to enter the bearish territory. This is the bearish territory where the double bottom, or in the price charts of the other cryptocurrency, this technical pattern, trend reversal pattern is. And I think that sooner or later, something like this may happen. The price will resume the uptrend. It may be from levels close to the neckline. For example, let's say from this range, it may turn out that we're at the very beginning of this growth and the price may start to resume the uptrend now or later or a little bit later. But we will see something like this, at least in my view. And I want to say that this formation is typical for trend reversal technical patterns. And in my view, one day when we check the price chart of this cryptocurrency and it looks like this, for example, we will even not be able to spot this local high because the price will continue in the next couple of years and so on. It's upward journey. This is our beautiful blockchain market. And many people then, once again, will get back here. They won't be able to spot this, the newbies that will enter the market here. But many experienced traders, they will see and say, yes, that was a typical example of how the trend reversal technical pattern works according to the textbooks, according to the what we have learned from the different financial markets. You have a trend reversal, technical pattern, a breakout, then the price drops and tests the borderline or this neckline in our case, and then it resumes the uptrend. So this is the very beginning of the uptrend in my view, and this is something normal. And I won't say that when I worked as a financial analyst in the forex market, in the stock market, many years ago, there was a colleague of mine, and he said that this formation, when the market tests the trend reversal borderline or the neckline, is called last kiss. So let me take the price of Monero once again. So they used to call this last kiss. So this is the price chart of Monero. So once again, and I even check in this trading in trading books, and they used to call this last kiss. So this is the neckline, this is the double bottom, this is the double bottom, and this is actually the last kiss. The market starts to increase, a breakout takes place, the price increases, then it drops, tests this key level, this border between the bearish territory and the bullish one. And this is the last kiss, because after that, a solid trend reversal or bull trend in our case starts. And that is just the last kiss before the solid bullish trend. And it is a last kiss after the trend reversal, because this is the very beginning of the bull market. And I want to say that a couple of months ago, I iterated that in my view, we're at the very, very beginning of some bull trend. I explained this many times in my videos. You can see it 3-4 months ago, because I think that this is, from fundamental point, from technical point, the very beginning of some bull market that will be a couple of years, at least 4, 5, 6. I don't know. Timing is very different to spot, but I want to say that we're at the very beginning of a solid bull market, and this is an example. This is the last kiss, at least in my view, as my colleagues, when I used to work as a forex and stock market analyst, we used to call this formation before the solid beginning of the bull trend. So that's it for today, fellas. This is my point of view. I don't claim that I am right. It's up to you. Please share your point of view as a comment under this video. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets. Enjoy the weekend, and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again, Edric Spark.